Okay, so today it is last day of the week. So next week we're taking new grabs. Do you say that? And new, what do you say? New week, new possibilities. But for now, this is the last story of this week. And it is about abuse. And it is called How Another Student Learned to Laugh at Abuse, Wisdom. The former story was from ancient India. The following story is from ancient Greece, where the method of education was very similar. A single teacher would teach his student everything. This was the story I told yesterday. I actually read the latter story today. One particular teacher was bad-tempered and would often scold a student for making the slightest mistake. Having verbally abused the young man, the teacher would then charge him for the privilege of being admonished. It was regarded as a tutorial, worthy of a fee to the teacher. One such student went to work in Athens after graduating. Whenever his boss or anyone else verbally abused him, the student would laugh merrily. In those days, one of the worst curses coming from the nearby Middle East was, "May the flesh from 1,000 camels infest your armpits." He even laughed at that. He did not get upset at any insult. His friends and colleagues thought he was a few pillars short of a Greek temple, but in all other matters he appeared sane, so they asked him why he always laughed when he was rebuked. "When I was a student," he replied, "I had to pay for being criticized. Now I get it for free. That is what makes me so happy." Perhaps we should charge our children every time we have to shout at them for not cleaning their room, or for not doing their homework, then later on in their lives, when their partner scolds them or a boss shouts at them, they will never get angry, only laugh merrily like that student of ancient Greece. Now they don't have to pay for the abuse. Yes, a helpful way to deal with abuse. And this story finish this week's set of stories. So let's get on for next week. But for now, your body, you saved the girl, your body. Yes, we have to celebrate. Bye bye.